Hello everyone, this is Mario, welcome back to my channel, and welcome to Stage 3 of the Critérium du Dauphiné 2019 in Pro Cycling Manager. So after two hilly stages where only about 30 riders in each stage managed to reach the end in the front group, we now have a sprinter-friendly stage. The final few kilometers are basically flat, and so Sam Bennett, Sonny Colbrelli and André Greipel are the favorites to take the stage win today. So, with Dara Limpi coming from two third-place finishes in the previous two stages and considered among the favorites for this stage, I will also try to win this one with him or with Luka Mezgek, so it will depend on who is feeling better in this stage. So, the riders are now departing from Le Puy-en-Velay. They are facing 172 kilometers today, and no surprises, I'm not going to put my riders in the breakaway for this stage. I'm going to try and win it with, I think, Dara Limpi, although Luka Mezgek is having a plus one race day condition, is still going to be on a 74 sprint stat, and Dara Limpi is on a 75. He also has a better resistance stat than Mezgek. So I will use Mezgek as the lead-out for Dara Limpi in this one. So today's breakaway is composed by 9 riders. We have Joey Roscoff, Mertz, Munoz, Stettina, Parche, Bonnet, also Anthony Roux, Sandro Rosseto, and Hagen. So 9 riders in today's breakaway. They are leading the peloton by 1 minute. And are approaching the first Category 4 climb of the day. So Joey Roscoff is the first one to attack in this day for the mountain points. It's only a Category 4 climb. I think it only gives 2 points, if I'm not mistaken. And it's Pache taking the points here, so he's kind of protecting the lead of his teammate Cyril Gauthier. So the riders in the breakaway are now in the Côte de Piboulet. They are 2 kilometers away from the top of this climb. Only 5 riders are left in this group. The other riders that were here in the beginning have dropped. They were out of energy and were eventually caught by the peloton. Pache is now attacking for the KOM points, so he's trying to protect his teammate Cyril Gauthier again. Let's see if he can get the points here. It's going to be Hagen. No, it was Sandro Rosseto taking the points here. The breakaway is now 1 kilometer away from the next climb. Joey Roscoff again in the front of this group, followed by Hagen. It's one of them taking the points here. The top points, it's going to be Hagen now. And already attacking for another climb. In the meantime, Bonnet was dropped from this group. It's going to be Joey Roscoff taking the points now. No one else is answering the American rider from CCC. Cyril Gauthier is still leading with 13 points, one ahead of Stefan Rosseto, and I've been calling him Sandro Rosseto for ages. So the breakaway is now 51 kilometers away from the finish line. They are still leading with almost 4 minutes over the peloton. So it might be challenging for the peloton to bring them back, although the difference has now been decreased to 3 minutes and 20 seconds, so the pace is increasing in the peloton, and it's not going to be that easy for these 5 men to keep ahead going to the finish line. So there was a fall a few kilometers back. Thibaut Pinot was actually caught in that fall. I don't think anyone abandoned here, but yeah, Pinot got dropped. Now his teammates are trying to bring him back to the front group, and it's not going to be easy. Also, is Colbrelli. Colbrelli is also here, so that's quite important. One of the favorites for today's stage has been dropped, so this might improve our chances to win the stage. So, with less than 20 kilometers to go and 1 minute separating the breakaway riders from the peloton. I have set a sprint train, so I'm going with Nick Schultz in the front, and I will try to win this with Dara Olympi using Luka Mezgek as a lead out. So we are now 8 kilometers away from the finish. The breakaway riders still have a small lead over the peloton. I'm increasing the pace now with Damien Alsen. Then it's going to be Diane Smith leading my train. And Dara Olympi, no, don't drop, Himpi. Don't do that. You're killing me, man. Let's use the energy gel now on Mezgek and Himpi. They are in the front of the race now. Diane Smith leading the sprint train. Let's see how this goes. Let's use energy gels and my other riders. Now Luka Mezgek is going to start pacing right now. And soon he will sprint also. Let's see. Let's sprint now with Mezgek. Keeping Himpi here. Let's sprint with Himpi now. Let's see if he can take the stage. No, it's going to be Sam Bennett or Kurt Nielsen. It's Magnus Kurt Nielsen, Andre Greipel, and Dara Olympi is again the third. How is this possible? I don't believe this. And I started the sprint with Himpi again too late. Ah, it was almost perfect. So in the end, Luka Mezgek was leading out Dara Olympi, but the South African started the sprint way too late. He still managed third place ahead of Sam Bennett, actually, which is not a bad result, but it was not a stage win. So Magnus Kort takes the win for Astana, his first win in this Dauphiné. He was followed by Andre Greipel, and then Dara Olympi managed his third place finish in this race. Magnus Kort is the new leader of the general classification after taking 10 more seconds. Dara Olympi keeps second place, now 4 seconds behind the leader, and Romain Bardet dropped to third. Cyril Gauthier managed to keep his mountain classification jersey thanks to the efforts from his teammate Quentin Paché. Magnus Kort still leads the points classification. But in the next stage, Dara Olympi will actually be wearing the green jersey because Magnus Kort will be the yellow jersey wearer. The best young rider is still Jenny Moscon, and the top team is still Team Ineos. So Magnus Kort was the best in the first mass sprint finish in this race. He was stronger than Andre Greipel and Dara Olympi. I managed another third place finish with Dara Olympi. It's, well, if he gets third place in all stages from now to the end of the race, he probably takes the win. But of course, that's not going to happen. For a while, Sam Bennett looked like he was going to take the win today, but then he was overtaken by other riders. So it was really close this time. I think I did almost everything perfectly. But in the end, maybe I should have tried to start the sprint with Himpi a bit sooner, and that would have given me a better chance to take the stage. So finally, the next stage will create some important gaps between the GC contenders. It's an individual time trial of 26.1 kilometers. It's hilly, so there's a little hill in the middle of the route. But it's not very steep, and probably time trial specialists are going to be the favorites for this one. Of course, Tom Dumoulin and Chris Froome are the top two favorites to take the stage win. They are also the top two favorites for the final GC. And it's up to the other GC contenders to not lose that much time in the next stage. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this stage. It was not a very eventful stage, but the final sprint was quite interesting, with Magnus Kort taking a surprise win here, and with Dara Olympi taking a third place finish for the third time in a row. So if you have enjoyed this, please like my video. Also, please comment below on what you think I should improve in my videos. And if you haven't done so and enjoy my videos, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate the support. And I hope to see you all next time for stage 4 of the Critérium du Dauphiné 2019 in Pro Cycling Manager. Bye!